I told you in my last video that I want to upgrade from the Canon M50 because after 1 year of using it now I want a better camera, I want better performance, I want a camera that can shoot good 4K with great autofocus, and I want a camera that can shoot 120 frames per second in 1080p. And I waited a while now for the Canon to announce a replacement for the Canon M50, but the last announcement from Canon, the Canon M50 Mark II, it is a big disappointment in my opinion. That's why I was balancing between Canon and Sony, because Sony has better APS-C mirrorless cameras. And in the end I decided to... stay with Canon. Why I bought the Canon R6? I will tell you in a few moments. First and foremost, I wanted a hybrid camera. I'm a beginner YouTube video creator, but I also like to take photos and I want to learn more about photography. So I don't want a dedicated video camera. I want a camera that can take good photos, but also to shoot good video. In the last few months, I watched many videos about Canon R6 and R5. I was following the prices of R6 here in Switzerland, and I was expecting a price drop, but around Christmas, not now. But in one weekend, I saw that one store here in Switzerland had a 10% discount for R6, so I just bought it. Big shout out to Interdiscount here in Switzerland, thank you for that discount. I had to wait about 10 days, but finally has arrived. Now let's talk a bit about what I know about the R6. R6 has a 20.1 megapixel sensor. It's the same sensor that you get in the Canon 1DX Mark III, the Pro Line camera from Canon. The 1DX Mark III from Canon costs around $6,000, something like that. If you are asking yourself if 20 megapixels are enough, taking into account that the previous R camera, the Canon R, had 30 megapixels and Canon R5 has 45 megapixels, well, many people are saying that it's enough. All you have to do is to compose better your image, your scene, because you can't crop too much the image. It shoots 1080p up to 120 frames per second, but many people are saying that the 120 frames per second in the R6 is not that good, whatever that means. I barely wait to check that out. It shoots 4K up to 60 frames per second, which is super sample from 5.1 megapixels. And it has a small crop of 7%. It has great autofocus in all shooting modes. It has great autofocus. It is much improved compared to the Canon EOS R, including eye tracking and animal eye tracking autofocus. One issue it could be that it's using IPB compression, comparing to the EOS R and the EOS R5, which are using all eye compression. For us, the beginners, all we have to know is that all eye compression gives you a higher quality than comparing to IPB, but it also produces files that are 3 times larger than the IPB compression. That means it's harder to handle those files if you don't have a powerful computer. I also saw many people here on YouTube saying that you cannot spot the difference between IPB and All-I. Maybe in the future Canon will unlock All-I for Canon R6 because it seems to work, but only in the time elapsed video mode. It shoots 10-bit, it is better in low light, also the dynamic range is better, it's not so good as in the Sony i7S3, but it's a lot better than in the Canon R. Even though it's the first IBIS developed by Canon, and by the way, it's the same IBIS that you find in the R5, it seems to be very good. It seems to be even better than the one that you find in the Sony cameras. It has 5 stops of image stabilization, but if you pair it with another Canon lens that also has image stabilization, it can go up to 8 stops of image stabilization. You can also use the EF lenses if you have, by using an adapter that costs about $100. It also has C-Log, so I can get into color grading, which is also something that I want to learn. It can shoot 12 frames per second with mechanical shooter and 20 frames per second in silent electronic mode with continuous autofocus. Those are the most important things that I remember right now. Now, let's see what's in the box. Okay, so we have some manuals. We have the new battery, LPA6NH. We have the battery charger. I think I got 3 years warranty from Canon. I'm not sure if that is just in Switzerland or it's worldwide, but it's great. Thank you, Canon, for that. Okay, the cable for charger. Some plastic. The camera strap with the EOS R6 logo. I didn't use this too much on the Canon M50. I'm not sure if I will use it for the R6, but it's great that it's there. 6 body. Feels great in the hand, but it's a lot bigger than the Canon M50. Yeah, it's a lot bigger than the Canon M50. Canon R6 has dual card slots for the SD cards, and the recommended ones are the new ones, the I think are called UHS-II, which can read up to 300 megabytes per second and can write up to 250 megabytes per second, if I'm not mistaken. But I'm gonna use the ones that I'm also using for the Canon M50, and those are the UHS-I. I have two of 64 gigabytes, and those can read up to 170 megabytes per second and can write up to 90 megabytes per second. I hope it's enough and I will not have problems with these ones. And the reason why I'm using these ones that I also use on the Canon M50 is the price, because the new ones are 3 times more expensive than the old ones. I purchased only the R6 body and not the kit lens, which I think is 24 to 105 and aperture between 4 and 7.1. And I don't think this kit lens is a good lens for videography, because you cannot get that cinematic footage. For that you need an aperture between 2.8 and 3.5. But I think for photography that kit lens, it's a good budget lens. So this was my first video about Canon R6. If you are interested in Canon R6 and Canon M50, you may want to subscribe to my channel, because more videos will follow. See you next time. Take care. Is that okay?